Hi guys, Stefan here from Joe Posh. So I'm here today to talk about something that is really important if you love your pet and if you believe that you need your pet to be with you for a long time. So let's talk about breeding or the standards of Sri Lanka. So mostly, let's say when you go to get a pup, so what you're mainly interested is, all of you guys, we always want to have a pup that's the cutest or the biggest, or the pup that looks more like the father. So, because right now in Sri Lanka, if you have a female dog and if you have pups from a male who is imported, it's considered to be one of the, let's say, how can I say it? It's considered to be as something that makes it easy for you to sell your pups, and it's a mindset where you believe that your pups will carry the genes of imported dog as well as a dog that is exactly made to look more of bulky or a dog that is having more quality, mainly because the dog is imported. So you prefer to have a mate with an imported dog because people believe that, you know, then your pups are going to be carrying the same genes, and they believe that the pups will also be exactly like the pup, like the father. So which means what I have experienced is that anyone having selling pups, they feed them so much that they look more fluffy and they make them to gain more weight. And as long as how I see it, or the facts of any large or medium dog, it has to be clear to everyone that a dog would take naturally 1 year to grow in height and 2 years to put on weight. And forcing that and, you know, feeding them just to look fluffy and all of that, that unknowingly it's nice for the eyes and people are happy, people believe that, okay, he's a well-bred dog and all of that. But then sadly, the sad reality is that the health of the pup is put into risk, because wherever we buy them, let's say in 2 years, that's when your dog is going to be an adult. And that's, and when you spend around 1 to 2 years, that's where your bond with your own pet is going to increase. And at that point, you lose your pet. He'll fall sick, he'll have joint problems and all of that. For example, let's take bulldogs. So bulldogs suffer a lot of breeding issues. And there are times where a lot of dogs have been operated on below their throat just to breathe. Because, for example, even pugs, they can't walk much. And if you feel that in Sri Lankan context, this contents, what I say is, what, let's say, to be honest, we all don't have this habit of, as Sri Lankans, our lifestyle is totally different from maybe Serbia or Russia or Croatia or Ukraine. Call it sick, in simple terms, Europe. It's our lifestyle is totally different. We don't jog on a regular basis. And I'm talking a basic way. So that a normal person who has a dog, even your dog is not going to be jogging or walking, or we don't have dog parks like we get in other countries. So one thing you can control is the food and the structure. And when your dog is not excessively large or, say, large or bulkier, it's easier for him. It's the system is made it's more easy life for him and a happy life. And this is in terms of the Sri Lankan answer. And another thing is, it's a fact that, you know, no matter how an imported father looks, your pup naturally, if he's born in Sri Lanka and if he's raised in the Sri Lankan weather climate, he's not going to definitely grow like the father. Because if a father is imported from Serbia, he's born there, and he at least in his life is to maximum of 8 months, he lives there. So then his body is immune to that climate and he gains weight. So for example, let's say you get down a male from Europe, unless you give him excess meals and excess food to make sure he looks the way he is, alright? In a couple of months, you feel a difference. If you just give the same diet, you will definitely feel a difference. And no matter what you say, you will definitely feel a difference because he won't have much. I mean, there are times where dogs with fur, their fur pattern changes. Basically, I do not. It's like they get evolved into the climate of the tropical climate of Sri Lanka. That's where Sri Lanka is, right? So, and then there are a lot of facts. Like, so they sell pups. You know, they feed them. For example, it's a Labrador. They say plant flesh Labrador. I mean, I really saw this. It's the name. It was advertisement. They advertised saying plant face Labrador pup for sale. So the meaning plant face is because they have that a flat face and wider jaws, or they look more chubby, or in simple terms it's chubby. So then they say plant face. It's basically marketing gimmick, because at the end of the day, I don't see why you need to, you know, make your pup look more fluffy and all of that just to sell them or just to get a higher price. And while customers are happy, I mean, when we see so much into a chubby and well built and all of that, we always forget that we need a dog who's gonna leave us with us for a maximum of 10 years of life. I mean, for example, I'm 25 years old, and from the day I was born up to now, I live with dogs, and it has been German Shepherds, Steve. This is my Rottweiler, and I have a lab as well, and I had a German Shepherd who lived 15 years, right? So 15 years was, I'm not saying that I had the best or I did it right. What I'm saying is, I did control in food, and there were times that he doesn't, you compare him with the imported dog, he's sometimes smaller, a little bit small, compact, but still, as a pet lover, for me, what matters is not my dog to look massive or fierce or what others think. For me, what matters is my dog living or being with me for more than 10 years. If that's not happening, it's a fail. So that's the basic knowledge. I just want to share my input. Have a good day, and let's meet again. Thank you.